Hello, everyone. This is Shelly here, and I represent Ampler Solar, which is one of the largest CNI distributed rooftop solar company in India. I am particularly heading the residential segment from Ampler Solar. I thank EQ for giving me this opportunity to be a part of this prestigious group of leaders and discuss some of the challenges that rooftop solar sector is experiencing in India. To begin with, I would just highlight some of the great things that has been happening in India. We have seen, according to the latest reports, that about 4 gigawatts of rooftop solar installations has happened in FY19. And if I'll see how we can proceed further to meet the huge targets of 100 gigawatt of solar overall by 2022, I also see some of the challenges that not only the developers are facing, but the other stakeholders in the whole ecosystem, which is the developers, the consumers, and the financing agents, they are also facing the similar challenges to take it up. From my perspective, I'll quickly touch base on some of the financing related challenges, and then I'll open the floor to my fellow team members here who can throw some light on the policy related challenges and the consumer demand issues. To talk about the financing related challenges, we have seen that a lot of the initial challenge has been to get the low cost financing solution for project financing from the market. We have seen that World Bank has given a huge fund of about $600 million to SBI through financing line. And a lot of players have taken advantage of that. But some challenges still persist. One would be, the one major challenge that I find is the kind of asset quality that they're looking for is quite difficult to achieve by all the developers. We have seen that the asset quality mix and the portfolio has not yet developed. Developers have solved this problem by creating a mix of low performing and high performing assets and create a portfolio for them, so that the banks would not have problem in financing those assets. Let's say if one particular asset is not performing at a particular point of time, they can say that all the revenue generation can be compensated by a high performing asset. So that's particularly about the diversification of the solar portfolio that developers should offer to the banks, so that they can ensure a continuous stream of revenue coming from these different asset qualities. The second point I would say that the huge list of compliances and inspections that these banks ask for that, there is one particular thing that the benchmarking of activities, the benchmarking of standard operations, the procedures is not done by these banks themselves. And in order to tackle that, there should be a conglomerate, there should be a way to identify or to create these benchmarks by working with these banks themselves, so that they can enforce these benchmarks on the other developers also. And that is the need of the hour, because I understand the stringent quality that they look for, the safety procedures that they look for, and if we not benchmark them, the other developers might not be able to make up to that or not understand that in order to get that finance from the banks. So enough said about the financing issues. I would like to keep the floor open. I would like to ask Mr. Manish if he can talk something about the policy issues that are coming up and what are the major deterrents which are not allowing the growth of rooftop solar in India. Mr. Manish.
I would like to start my remarks like that. There is one saying, sky is the limit as far as the rooftop projects are concerned, rooftop solar is concerned. Roofs are the limits. And then all roofs are, most of the roofs are at the moment empty. So we can, there is an empty space to play for everyone to play for this rooftop. And as far as the, like Shelly has asked me to about brief you about the policy, what policies are in the Gujarat at the moment and what are the constraints. So at the moment, as everybody, most of the people knows that there is a one PGVCL tender is going on for 600 megawatt, and this is one of the biggest tender in the India as far as the rooftop tender is concerned in subsidy. But there are so many constraints, and we were facing about first of all the this tender floating tender, then finalization of tender terms, and then not clearing the vague terms and condition in the tender. So whole process took about 7-8 months. Now only just 1 month back, government has clarified few terms, and now these tender terms are being picked. Now this tender is picking up for the implementation. And constraint which we are facing at the moment, as far as the rooftop is concerned, the structure, PDI, and now most of the terms has been clarified, and I believe now that this will be picking up very fast, and by 31st March, although government has, Mr. Mukesh has said that government wants to install 2 lakh system, but we EPC player, we are into the market, and we know that not more than 1 lakh, maximum 1 lakh, maybe because government, we don't have resources, government don't have resources. So maximum 150 to 200 megawatt would be completed before 31st of the March. This is the known fact, although we should have the big target always. As far as this residential is concerned, now anybody can install any capacity irrespective of their contract demand. And if we talk about the commercial government, their INC, the commercial and industrial C&I, which we call, at the moment there is one big constraint is that we can install only 50% of our contract demand. That too is the, again, 90.9% power factor. So effective installation permissible is only 45% of your contract demand. Then we have represented to the CM level, and then energy minister, and then minister Mr. Mukesh and Shetal sir, and everybody we have represented, then they come out with a new policy for MSME, and in which they have allowed 100% or even more than that. If anybody wants to install any industrial other than residential, industrial, manufacturer, industrial customer, if he wants to install solar power project on his roof as well as on anywhere else, he can install more than 100% of his contract demand. But there are so many clauses and riders that amendment is effectively ineffective. Like what they did, they have imposed electricity duty on whatever power you will produce through solar power. And the current rate is 60 paisa, which can be increased and which can be decreased in the future. First thing is that, so you have to pay 60 paisa. So far there was no electricity duty on on repower for 10 years. So one clause is there now, ki you have to pay 60 paisa duty. Another clause, which is not in favor of MSME. Most of the MSME used to have the weekly off on their factories, and the other clause which is not good is that if you are not using the power which you are producing within 15 minute time slot, that power will goes to the DISCOM, and you will be paid 1.75 rupees for that extra power which you have not, ABT meter, that is known as ABT meter, if you are not using that. So, and then it is not clear on 1.75 rupees you have to pay electricity duty as well or not. So if you have to pay for that, that means effectively whatever solar power you are producing, you are getting 1.15 rupees, which is not in favor of solar industry at all. So sometimes we don't understand whether government wants to promote solar industry or they want to discourage it. Because this MSME circular which they have come out is not in favor of MSME. Similarly, if anybody wants to install OPEX method for solar power project on the rooftop, industrial rooftop, that is not allowed in Gujarat. That is a very big market. Most of the, many industries, they don't want to invest in their solar plant. They have their different priorities. But if anybody wants to install solar power project, if anybody wants to go, anybody wants to invest in third party process, that is known as OPEX method. That is not allowed. As OPEX is allowed at the not other than other than his roof. So these are the few basic restrictions which is stopping the growth of the solar projects, solar power in Gujarat. But still, the by far, the Gujarat policies are better than the rest of the India. That much I can say, because we are working into the Maharashtra, MP, Rajasthan, and Gujarat. So this much I can say.
Thank you, Mr. Manish. I understand that Gujarat has been the pioneer in developing the rooftop solar segment all over India. And it has recently come up with the biggest tender of residential segment, 600 megawatt. But apart from the policy issues that Mr. Manish has highlighted, there are certain issues which are related to net metering also and the availability of DISCOM in materializing those challenges. Can I have Mr. Ankit also, who can speak something about the challenges that he has faced in the CNI segment specifically?
Thanks, Shelly, for handing me over. As rightly shared, said by Mr. Manish, that sky is the limit. Yes, sky is the limit where we can see the roof, we have our market, right? And after this residential scheme, automatically the market has been picked. And we all sitting in this room are feeling the same, that there's a demand coming in. And in earlier years, there were people started trying solar. They were started putting a small solar plants in their factories and they were just trying it out, that is it fine or not. Now they have, you know, tasted solar and they have realized that it is beneficial. And in the current economic scenario, even FD, even properties and nothing else gives that return which solar is giving. So which we can, you know, convince the market, and there is a complete demand in the market. Secondly, if I talk about the residential subsidy scheme which is there, so which Manishji was saying, that the lot of policies and lot of, you know, tender requirement which is there. So even if I talk about the pricing which is there, which is very difficult to work for a EPC player. So and to sustain that project for 5 years, it's, you know, a lot of constraints which are there to accomplish that target. In commercial sector, the recent MSME policies which are there, but if it is in the favor of MSME or if it is not in the favor of MSME, which is not clear, and how to put up that 100% or more than 100% of the demand, how to do the paperwork, and what is the process of achieving that MSME requirement, it is also not clear till now. But the huge market is there if everything is sorted out in MSME sector, because Gujarat being rich in industrial segment and they have lot of MSMEs. So if the processes will be cleared and all the loopholes which we have in the mind, which is clear, automatically that market will going to rise. And if I talk about the open access challenges, so let's take example, some industry which is there in UP or Haryana, and they are taking power at 4 rupees or 4.5 rupees through open access. And some industry which is there in Gujarat and which is producing the same product and taking a power at rupees 8 or 8.5. So that will make Gujarat industries incompetitive, because the overhead cost is the electricity. And if you are not taking the electricity at the same price which your competitor is taking, automatically that will bring the economy down, and that will bring the name of the Gujarat is in industries. And if they don't have that edge which the other company or other competitor is having in other state, automatically they will not going to survive in the future. So that must be think upon, and that must be worked upon, that how they will be going to compete in the future. As we are not talking about the solar EPC player, we are talking about as a consumer or a industrialist who is working in Gujarat, and as an industrialist who is working in other state. So what will happen to them after 2 years if some of their competitors is taking power at a lower rate, right? So that is the point which I want to touch upon, and over to you, Sherry. Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Ankit. Mr. Narya, can you shed some light on your experiences with the challenges that you have faced, and then we'll probably discuss how we can look up to these challenges and solve them. Over to you, Mr. Narya.
Thank you, Sally. It is similar thoughts, just like said by Manish sir. We are experiencing a mix of policy and exposure from government because MSME policy and JEDA, whatever we have solar policy 2015, we have an aggressive target. But do government is promoting solar or not? It is the question. Because government is telling that we are pumping money through some residential schemes, sky scheme, but and also they want if they want to such achieve such an aggressive target, we have to invest private equity, and we have to welcome all this investor, but government is not looking that kind of thing. And they are not promoting RESCO models in Gujarat. Only open access is promoted through tendering process, but it is not lucrative as the rate is going very low. And we can say that it is more or less mix of exposure for the EPC developer as well as EPC partners to survive in the future. And government is discovering benchmarking rate and keeping it very low as far as concern from the end. Moreover, right now customer are telling that benchmark is rate so and so, and we can do PPA on the EPC as what we can say very large scale ground mounted project that they are taking as a reference. So more or less we are facing some saturations and some resistance from government, and that we have to look out, and we have to come out from this bottlenecks. So we need first one policy for the entire nation, not for the state to state, and metering norms, because distributed space is not a large scale project. It's a small and patches project. So we need to discuss the concerns, whatever the on ground, not on the compared to large scale. So more or less, government needs to take this opportunity and not only allow government funding and private funding. They need to allow private equity also. They need to allow some investors. And then only we can achieve, because right now if you see the trend of JEDA where distributed all these projects are registered, but you see just last 6 month trend tells that it is around 6 to 7 megawatt per month. So it is around 70 to 80 megawatt per year. So we are not going to achieve our 1700 megawatt target by 2020. So it is a big concern, and our policy is going to expire by next March. So government needs to be looked into the policy to achieve this target. That's all from my thing.
Thank you, Mr. Narya. We have clearly identified that the challenges are of great fold across MSME, across the policy guidelines defined. In terms of the penalty that has to be levied on 60 paisa. And these policies, definitely we would discuss about how we can tackle these policies. I would request Mr. Mukesh ji, if he can have his 2 cents on how we can tackle these challenges.
Abhi. दो तीन दोस्तों ने अपने अपने जो विचार इस स्कीम को प्रमोट करने के लिए जो बताए हैं, नो डाउट ये पहली बार इस स्कीम का इम्प्लीमेंटेशन हम डिस्कॉम के द्वारा कर रहे हैं, तो टेंडरिंग और अदर्स प्रोसीजर करने में टाइम बहुत गया है, और इसकी वजह से अब इस साल के टारगेट को अचीव करने के लिए सिर्फ 3 महीने ही हमारे पास बचे हैं। तो मनीष जी ने राइटली बताया कि इस 3 महीने में हम ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा 100 या 150 मेगावाट का ही काम कर पाएंगे. नेक्स्ट ईयर अब ये डिस्कॉम के द्वारा ही हम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन करेंगे इस स्कीम को, तो इतनी दिक्कतें नहीं आएगी और स्मूथली इस स्कीम को हम अप्रैल 2020 से ही शुरू कर देंगे. सोलर पॉलिसी को भी फिर से हमें अब एक साल के बाद उसको रिन्यू करके नई पॉलिसी, सोलर पॉलिसी जो हमें डिक्लेयर करनी है. तो आप लोगों के जो जो भी सुझाव है, जो भी सजेशन है, आप काइंडली हमें क्लाइमेट चेंज डिपार्टमेंट या एनर्जी पेट्रोकेमिकल्स डिपार्टमेंट को आप सबमिट कर देना. तो नए सोलर पॉलिसी का गठन करते वक्त उस सभी सजेशन को भी हम ध्यान में रखते हुए इस प्रकार हमारे 2022 का टारगेट को हम इजीली अचीव कर सके, तो उसी प्रकार को ध्यान में रखते हुए, आपके सजेशन को सबको ध्यान में रखते हुए हम सोलर पॉलिसी का उस प्रकार हम गठन करेंगे. जो भी तकलीफें, जो भी मुश्किलें आपको गवर्नमेंट की ओर से इस स्कीम को इम्प्लीमेंट में करने में पड़ रही है, तो उसके लिए मैं खेद व्यक्त करता हूँ. इन फ्यूचर आपको गवर्नमेंट की ओर से पूरा सपोर्ट मिले, जिड़ा की ओर से पूरा सपोर्ट मिले, उसकी हम कोशिश करेंगे. और आप सबके सहयोग से ही हमें ये 2022 का टारगेट अचीव करना है. तो आप सबसे, मैंने अभी पहले भी बताया कि आप सबसे बहुत बड़ी उम्मीदें लेकर गुजरात सरकार ने ये 2022 का टारगेट अचीव करने का एक यज्ञ शुरू किया है. निरंतर आप लोगों का साथ सहकार हमें मिलता रहे और हम आपके सहयोग से इस काम को सहलाई से पार कर सके, इसकी उम्मीद है. जो भी आपके सजेशन सुझाव होंगे उसको हम ध्यान में रखते हुए आगे इस प्रकार काम करेंगे कि जिससे जो पास्ट में आपको जो डिफ़िकल्टीज़ महसूस करनी पड़ी है वो दोबारा महसूस करने ना पड़े, उसका भी सरकार की ओर से हम ध्यान रखेंगे.
मुकेश जी ने जो बात बोली, सर आपको खेद व्यक्त करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. आप जब कभी भी हमको कोई प्रॉब्लम होती है, हम आपके पास में आते हैं, आप हमको सॉल्यूशन देते हैं, तो हम आपको खेद व्यक्त आपको नहीं करना, हम आपको थैंक्स बोलते हैं उसके लिए. पहली बात आपका. और दूसरी बात सर, एक थोड़ा क्लेरिफिकेशन चाहिए था कि ये जो स्कीम 31 मार्च 2020 तक है, ये जो 600 मेगावाट वाली, जो हमारा इम्प्रेशन है, ये शायद अगले 18 महीने के लिए आई है लॉन्च. तो ये स्कीम कंटिन्यू रहेगी अगर इसके अंदर ये जो 2 लाख घरों का टारगेट है, विल हैपन. अभी अभी 31 मार्च तक ही है. नहीं, मैं पूछना चाह रहा हूँ, क्लेरिफिकेशन लेना चाह रहा हूँ कि क्या ऐसा है क्या? हमको क्लैरिटी नहीं है अभी, ये 31 मार्च को ही ख़त्म हो रही है. तो ठीक है सर.
थैंक यू कलीग्स, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल. Manish ji, the at right platform, the continuation of this scheme will be announced. I think this is a platform of brainstorming. So I would also like to put some of the views of the government's priority. So as you have observed since last 2 decades at least, since we launched the Jyotigram Yojana, Gujarat has been a pioneer in uninterrupted power supply. So that is the first thing. And nobody can doubt about the quality power supply by the government DISCOMs and the financial health of those DISCOMs. Then second thing of the government priority is energy access to everyone. So we are providing energy access based on the demand from every sector, including agriculture, industries and residential. Another important thing is there is no price hike from the customer level since many years. So this is the only commodity which is decreasing in terms of the expenditure. Then another important thing from government DISCOM is that they do not want to make profit. So there is not profit motive in energy supply system by the government. At the same time, there is also not motive of any making any loss. So government cannot afford loss making DISCOM. And Gujarat is the only state in the country where such financial health has been achieved. And otherwise we used to know there used to be many theft cases and so many losses in the grid. So our grid efficiency is also very important. At the same time, we have just seen that in the Madrid, Spain, the 25th conference of party was concluded before 2-3 days. But the commitment of India is very bright even in that forum. Even though the most advanced country and most developed country are not taking their responsibility towards climate change the way they should have taken it up. But our Prime Minister, our Chief Minister are very committed. And therefore, our Honorable Chief Minister in September itself announced that there will be no new coal-based power plant in Gujarat. What does it mean? It clearly means that there will be only renewable energy that is going to happen in Gujarat. So we have never said that we will reduce our ambition or target towards solar industry. But we have to keep things in a very broad way, and there is always a rules of game. So whenever we play test match or one day or 2020, there is a fixed set of rules that we all have to follow. And we know that what to do when tie happens. And we don't like India to lose World Cup from England the way we it happened this time. So, but we have to accept at the end only one player can be the winner. So it is not a lose of India as a team. So as a team, we are all working towards the progress of solar sector. And we know we have to tap the leakages. So there was a time in 2009 when Mukesh sir said we started our journey of the climate change department and also the solar policy. So we also have paid 14 rupees, 15 rupees, 16 rupees. So government is still paying those dues in terms of power purchase agreement of that time and that era. But now we have a different scenario. So definitely we have tried to make as wholesome as possible the MSME policy or any of the document. And we have JERC and many authorities and also RPO regime and the Government of India guidelines. But Niti Aayog is very clear. We have rather ambitious target of 450 gigawatt by 2030. So the sector is improving in any case. Even if only 1% of the surface area is covered with solar, we have 85 gigawatt in Gujarat itself from solar. So whoever player will come to this sector will have only better time in future, but they will have to have the capacity, they will have to play with the finance available with them. If we will they borrow limitlessly and then if they fall in the trap, then it should not be the case. Subsidy is only to promote and only to support. And ultimately, power is also going to be deregulated from all subsidies the way diesel have been deregulated before 5 years. So we have highly subsidized agriculture power. At the same time, we have some more burden on the commercial and the industrial side. So we know that in any case, we have to deregulate the power, and it has to be on market mode basis, and it has to be competitive. And also the producer will also have more responsibility in terms of uninterrupted power supply and things like that. So based on the climate change commitments, Gujarat is progressing, and definitely in budget speech of Honorable Deputy Chief Minister this year, it is announced that we have the ambition and we are going to continue with the scheme. But whatever framework that is again worked out based on the present experience will be announced by the highest authority on the right platform. But at least today we can say that we are going to continue with the momentum, and we require support from all walks of life, including the manufacturer, installer, supplier, and also now more responsibility and awareness is coming from the customer side. So you also have to be very responsible, very genuine in delivering the things. And in government sector also, we are bringing more money to install solar rooftop in government buildings and also in the schools and the hospital buildings. So these are all areas where we are working for decentralized power generation.